Everybody, it's HBCU game day. It is a Tuesday afternoon. We have some breaking news here. Dawson Odoms is leaving Southern University. He's headed to Norfolk State, back to the MEAC. Our Stephen J. Gaither broke the news today. Stephen, let's start with you, man. I did not see this coming. I spoke to Dawson Odoms as late as yesterday on a SWAC conference call. Sounded like he was getting ready for the summer and the fall at Southern University. So break it down for us. How did we get here where he's on the way out of what may have been one of the best teams in the SWAC this year?
Yeah, I mean, really a crazy turn of events. I mean, as the last year has been, but it really started last month. I mean, you have Latrell Scott leaving to take the job at East Carolina as tight ends coach. So that created an opening there. There was some discussion as to whether or not they should make the change because, again, we're, you know, normally you make these kind of changes after one season, which is in December or January. So, you know, there was discussion about that. And then over on Dawson Odoms and over Southern, I mean, like you said, I mean, they finished with a great record. They're nationally ranked. They're 19th in the country right now. So usually you don't see that as a situation where most coaches would leave where they are to go and start somewhere new. But over the weekend, started hearing some rumors that there may be a coaching switch from the MEAC to the from the SWAC to the MEAC. And, you know, yesterday there were some clues kind of thrown around or whatever. But I think, I think a lot of people are taken aback by this. But I think it makes a lot more sense than maybe people realize when you start to get some of the things besides just the win and loss record.
Yeah, I did a little bit of digging, just asking around after you put it out on Twitter today that you were working to confirm it. I did hear maybe there's a situation where he wanted some more money. Southern wasn't willing to come off of the money or didn't have it or whatever the case might be. Do you have any sense that this was maybe a financial move?
Well, I mean, you know, it's that very well could be. I mean, money always comes into play with it. I mean, for everybody, it's a reality. You know, the reported salary range difference from some of the media outlets necessarily isn't that much more than is it kind of in the same range that he was making in Baton Rouge. And, you know, I haven't done the cost of living analysis, but I don't know how much difference the cost of living is in Norfolk than it is from there. But, you know, I think a lot of times, you know, when we think about coaches, we pretty much think recruiting, wins and losses and things like that. But, you know, you're always hearing that our folks satisfied with not only their salaries, but their coaches' salaries, because that puts a cap on what type of coach they may be able to afford for their coaching staff. You know, and also they're, you know, just different type of resources and how resources are allocated. You know, so they have, you know, Southern has been a school that in the last 30 years or so, since they hired your former PE teacher, P. Richardson, to take over their program, they've gotten used to winning, and Dawson Odoms did a lot of that winning. But you know, you never know some of the things that go on in the program behind the scenes. We won't necessarily really know. You know, he's been there since 2012. He was the longest running coach in the SWAC. Everybody else had to change at least once, and some people more than once. But he'd been a model of consistency. I just wrote that article last year. But even in that consistency, there'd been turnover on the staff. You know, he's had guys go on to become head coaches elsewhere, his former teammate, Trey Oliver at North Carolina Central. So I think that there, you know, it's one of those things you never really know. And then Southern also is a place where there's high pressure to win there, maybe more so than there are at other places, including Norfolk State.
Yeah, well, just coming off a big grambling Southern Bayou Classic, Spring Classic, mollywop of grambling. That had to go over well with Jaguar Nation. But let's get back to Odoms. He's from North Carolina. He played football at North Carolina Central. He's coached in the MEAC. He's coached at A&T and some other places. So he's back on the East Coast, which is familiar territory for him.
Yeah, very familiar territory for him. He played in the 90s when North Carolina Central had one of the best defenses in the CIAA in Division II. He played again with Trey Oliver and Adrian Jones, who's a coach over at Shaw. He's from the area outside of Charlotte. And so he's very familiar with the East Coast, Carolina's Virginia. And so I think definitely it's a situation where I think he's still been able to pull some players from that area over the last couple of years to Southern. So I think it's going to be a chance for him to get a little bit closer to home and family. It's a nice ride to Baton Rouge. It's a lot shorter to Norfolk from the 704. So I think that there are a lot of benefits for him at Norfolk State to go there. I think the question is going to be the same question that has been around Norfolk State, kind of like those same 30-year run we're talking about with Southern, where Norfolk State has not had a coach to finish with a winning record since the mid-90s. You know, they've had questions about the resources that they've been able to allocate. You know, there have been questions about them and their financial situations. But obviously, Coach Odom saw something that he liked there at Norfolk State that not necessarily that maybe he didn't like at Southern, but maybe something that he just liked enough to make that move. And sometimes, you know, you get to a place where you've had a level of success and, you know, it's necessarily not always good enough for everyone. So Southern, a lot of folks will kill for the record that Southern has had over the last decade, four division championships, a championship game with appearances, dominated the Bayou Classic for the most part, and then also, you know, the SWAC Championship in 2013. So we'll see what happens with them. Obviously, there'll be a lot of folks who will want that job. It's going to be tough getting it in mid-year if you're outside of the staff. But as we see with Norfolk State, when a school wants someone, they'll try to go get them.
Yeah, well, Dawson Odoms from Shelby, North Carolina, he's definitely his own man and does things his way, that's for sure. Real quickly, before we let you go, Stephen J. Gaither breaking the news today that Dawson Odoms resigning from Southern University, headed to Norfolk State. Wow, the SWAC has been on fire the last few months. Exposure, HBCUs in general, the last two big coaching hires, now we'll say the last three big coaching hires have all, man, generated a lot of news. Now the ball is in Southern's court. What direction do you think they could possibly go? Is it an arms race, or do they take their time and maybe go to interim route? They got a strong team coming back. Your early thoughts on the opening now at Southern?
Yeah, well, you know, being on the outside in, you know, I would think that there would probably be a lot of folks who might want someone being there at Southern. I would think someone tied into the Pete Richardson era, whether that's someone who coached underneath him or played for him. I'm sure there's a list of guys there that they would like to have. But then, you know, like you say, there's the monkey in the room. There's the prime time element that Deion Sanders has brought to Jackson State. And then now you saw Eddie George going to Tennessee State University. So I'm sure there are going to be folks who are going to want them to make a splash higher in regards to somebody who can, you know, like you always say, win the press conference. Jackson State did that. Tennessee State has done that. Southern, you know, sees themselves in that same class. So will they look to do the same thing? You know, you just heard about some of the guys who are interested in coaching. You hear about Ray Lewis. You hear about Ed Reed, you know, and obviously I'm sure there's some more guys who maybe have some ties to that area. But I think it's going to be very interesting to see how they handle this. Again, I think, you know, again, talking with some of the folks around the program in Norfolk State, they were worried about, you know, hey, we're at the middle of the year. This is not really the best time to be bringing in a new coach to start something new when we're trying to get ready for a fall season that actually is going to culminate in someone going to the Celebration Bowl from both sides. So I think Southern has a lot of ways to look at this, a lot of ways that they can play it. You know, it's definitely going to be interesting now with everything that's gone on in the last 8 months or so, hiring Deion Sanders and Eddie George. And I don't know, Ed Reed at Southern might be a little bit interesting. Get down there, Florida, shake it up with FAMU and those guys would be pretty interesting.
Wow. Well, there's a lot to talk about, and we are in the business of talking, so this conversation will continue. But for now, let's be in the business of clapping, giving it up. Stephen J. Gaither breaking the news. Whether he gets credit or not with other publications, you know the truth. You saw it first at HBCU Game Day. Stephen, I know you got other people that want to talk to you. We'll let you go, but we'll definitely follow this as the news. The speculation will continue. Who takes over at Southern and wow, Dawson Odoms at Norfolk State. It's big. It's really big. Stay tuned here at HBCU Game Day and HBCUGameDay.com.